for more yards than any quarterback in the country last year. Tonight, Marshall's Rakeem Cato takes the first step toward becoming more than just a conference player of the year. Tonight begins the Thundering Herd's march to a championship.
Oh, it is finally here, the first Saturday night of college football from Huntington, West Virginia. The Marshall Thundering Herd hosting the Miami Redhawks, and Rakeem Cato leads his team on the field.
Well, they run a lot of plays, about 90 plays a game. Wear a defense out, that's exactly the goal for Doc Holliday.
But this humidity will be a factor. It's the Bud Light opening kickoff, and here we go.
Scott from the two. Takes it out across the 20. A 20-yard return out to the 22-yard line as Corey Tingle takes him down. Scott comes in motion. Boucher will throw to him. Behind the line of scrimmage, he's taken down at the 30-yard line by Tingle. A loss of four on the play.
Great recognition by Corey Tindall. He'll be on the right side of your screen. As soon as he recognizes the pass, he is closing and getting ready to make this tackle when that ball's not even halfway there. That's great anticipation.
To the line, run the play, get it going, and they've done so. Handoff straight up. Israel Taliaferro. Second down and three. Straight up the middle, and Westbrook is pounded at the 45-yard line.
How about Jermaine Holmes? Looking like a middle linebacker, hitting like a middle linebacker. That was knees bent, hips exposed, arms wrapped. You got nowhere to go.
Boucher to give. And guess who's back there, Randy?
Jermaine Holmes coming from that middle linebacker spot again. You figure you got a kid like this, you got a new defense, you start moving some bodies around, you get Holmes inside, he just comes burning up the field along with a little help from Jarquez Samuel that gets nice penetration on that.
And we'll keep it. And there's not much there. Good penetration. Neville Hewitt was in. They'll end around. Austin Green. Again, not much there. Herd defense ready for this one. Evan McKelvey in on the stop after the game of three.
Hey, Brad, you know who's in, you've been in on the game here the last couple of possessions? The big freshman, Buchanan. Colin Buchanan is playing at right tackle. We were in the elevator earlier today with his parents. Colin Buchanan's what, 6'5", about 3'10"?
And 17 years old.
17, folks. 17 starting in his first game at this level.
Third down and six. Steve Mark running in, now setting himself in the slot. Now motions to the backfield. Boucher ran into Westbrook and gets crushed. Back to the original line of scrimmage. Hewitt was there and got some help. And that's the first three and out for the Red Hawks.
That was a legitimate, flustered-looking play. The play clock was getting right down to the bloody end. They got the snap off. An attempt at a handoff did not go well for the fake, and they were all over that play inside for the Thundering Herd. So that's the kind of defense the Herd's used to. Getting that offense back with good field position now.
Murphy to kick on four. Driving kick. Roush inside the 25. Has the edge. And across midfield. A 47-yard punt, but Roush brings it back for 26 yards before Jay Mastin takes him down.
Man, that was a blur. Talk about a return.
Hey, if you come to Huntington, you got to spend some time with Patty. Fat Patty's, 3rd Avenue, about 100 yards from Jones C. Edwards Stadium. Best burgers in town? Well, how about Pruitt's? Maybe the best steaks in town down in Pullman Plaza. We spent a little time there. There's Bob Pruitt on the field. He was the man with that 96 undefeated team. Sent a few players on their way to greater things. Spencer Treadwell in the backfield. Give it to him. And he is met right now. Yes, that is the son of Don Treadwell, who lost 2 yards on that play.
What he lost was about all good common sense, the way that whole defensive front in the middle got a hold of him and smacked him. So far tonight, 0-3, Marshall on 3rd downs.
Cato to throw, steps up, will run with it. Makes a move. Rakeem Cato has their first down. Sliding down across the 37-yard line.
That's a smart move, too, by Rakeem Cato. He gets his first down. He buys his time. Look at this move. Whoop. Just real quick, sharp inside. He goes down. See how he landed right on his right elbow, though? Look at the way he goes down on the ground. That's the way to leave a little ground round in that turf, dude.
From the 37. Finally some room for Grooms up the middle, and he'll take it across the 45-yard line in front of Mitchell Winters.
Look how quick these guys get going. When they get their rhythm going, they're fast as anybody in the country.
Hand off, first down. 2 plays, and just like that, they're in Miami territory.
Okay, now right now you're seeing them operate, Brad, at their pace.
Grooms again for the 3rd straight time. Inside the 30. One man to beat. Can't beat him, but he's down inside the 15-yard line.
A Marshall kind of drive. Good pace.
Taliaferro to the 1. Jay Maston saved the touchdown.
Seems like 10 seconds.
Cato, the give. Touchdown. Ezra Taliaferro. 1 yard touchdown run to knot this game at 7. 10:04 to go in the first half. Grooms did to set this touchdown up, Randy.
Well, here's Grooms, but here's Chris Jaspers. Check him out. He's the center. Offensive coordinator Bill Legg says he knows every single position, every single block that has to be made. Wasn't a fantastic job of moving. In fact, he says Chris is not our most athletic lineman, but he sure knows where he's supposed to be, and he makes up for that. This hurry-up style, operate the way it's supposed to be operated.
Cato rolling, plenty of time. Now we'll bring it down, take it himself, break a couple of tackles, slide across the 40 for another first down.
What he's seeing out of the front, that's going to tell him which play he's running.
On 2nd down and 5, Butler with a hole and another first down into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. Chris Wade in on the stop, Randy.
And that plays into the whole idea that, you know, Doc Holliday's got a quarterback that, you hear the term coach on the field. In this offense, you literally need a guy running the offense that could be a coach.
Butler one more time. Shakes a couple tackles. Takes a big pop and flies forward for another 3 yards, down close to the 42-yard line.
Gotta watch Cato. Cato gets up there, immediately goes to the sideline for a signal. He's the guy that tells the line to get down. He's the guy that tells the backs where to line up. Here comes the next snap.
On 4th down, Butler pushes forward for the first down and much more inside the 35.
So, you know, that snap to snap.
Cato rolling. Throwing near side. Complete inside the 25-yard line. He's got Shuler.
So that means the defense has to get stretched. That means they almost have to run sideline to sideline every play.
On 2nd down and 5. Taliaferro, a fresh body. Left side, inside the 5. It's 1st and goal, Hurd. Shouting instructions now with Taliaferro in the backfield. Looks to throw. Fade, right side. Shuler! Touchdown!
Got any Steeler fans out there? Remember the Santonio Holmes fade in the Super Bowl against Arizona?
This a reminder for you?
Just a beautiful job. Not a big receiver. He manages to press that thing into the DB and then just race him to the sideline with a pinpoint pass coming from his quarterback.
Second down and 8. Boucher to throw again under pressure. He dumps it to Scott, and he is in the backfield. Drop the ball. It's loose. No signal yet. Hunter coming back the other way.
I heard a whistle.
The 40. I heard a whistle. He continues to run, and he's in the end zone. We're waiting on a signal.
Tell me that ball didn't come out when the player was on the ground, though. I mean, A.J. Leggett, he made the hit and broke that ball loose. It sure looked like the receiver was on the ground when that ball hit.
Look at it one more time.
Where is he? Makes the turn.
Nope,
it's out. That's a fumble. Leggett does a great job of stripping that ball out of there.
You and I both heard a whistle.
Yes. That ball comes out. Leggett holds him up, knocks the ball out. That's going to stand after replay.
An 82-yard return.
We did hear a whistle. This play is coming back. Listen. You can't hear it there, but it was about 2 seconds after the fumble. There was a whistle on the play.
Can we hear it this time?
I guess the sound of a whistle carries up and not as a fumble.
So what you're saying is, even though we got no touchdown signal, it's going to end up a touchdown.
We could have a change of possession. Is it a fumble? Yes. When that ball's coming out, there is no part of the offensive players.
Okay, well, here's the question there. Are you telling me you're sure he has possession, makes a football move before he lost the ball, or did he ever have possession?
I played offense, and I'd still say that was an offensive possession that was stripped out and caused a fumble.
It's taking them a long time to figure out.
The ruling on the field is that the ball was not completed of a catch. It is now going to be third down for Miami, Ohio.
See, not a completed pass.
So you on offense said, I liked it as a possession, but somebody upstairs did not.
I think I could find a few people in green shirts that might agree with me that was a completed pass.
I think Doc Holliday might be one as well. What can Cato do? Throw a long far side. Complete. Rouse out of bounds. Inside the 45. And that didn't take too long. Cato the snap. Steps up. Dumps. Talaferro has a first down in Red Hawk territory, down at the 42-yard line. Schuler's in the slot left side. Cato the throw, looking that side pump, bring it down inside the 35. And we'll drop inside the 30. Ah, beautiful night in Huntington, West Virginia. We are at halftime, overlooking the Ohio River. All knotted up at 14.
Rakeem Cato will give them every chance to win. For Boucher and company to stay in this game, to keep this game where it's at, for them to stay close, look up in the middle of the fourth quarter and go, hey, we can win this. They can't have turnovers.
Well, they had some dropped passes, or the score might be different at halftime, but we're knotted up. Butler's back deep as they won the toss and deferred. They get the first half, or the first second half possession, and Butler breaks loose, strings out left side across the 35. Rakeem Cato.
Oh, there were sacks, there were bad snaps.
There was spotty protection, but when he started pulling the ball down, he got the pace going. He got this offensive going with his feet.
Wants to get in rhythm to start the second half. On second and three, there's Shuler. Room to run. Make one man miss. Spin out of another. Into Red Hawk territory short of the 45.
That's pure two-on-one football. Probably the closest thing you see to it. That and Rich Rod, Arizona maybe.
About 24 seconds on that one, and it leads to a first down. Wilkins inside the 30 before he's run out of bounds by Maston. Snaps at 22. Wilkins goes to grab and knocked away. Terrell Jones was there in coverage.
You gotta
and
love.
Yet they call it a completion.
Look at Rakeem Cato and the accuracy.
Oh my.
He got it. Ball's down. He holds on to it. That's a catch.
Oh my. From the 30. Cato. Give it to Talaferro. He has to adjust. Finds the sideline looking for the markers, and he may have gotten it.
Was he going to be marked out of bounds? Yep, right at the marker.
He got to the 20. And they'll move the chains. They had him stopped 2 yards deep in the backfield.
What a great effort by a young man that the coaches speak so glowingly about what a leader he is.
He is one of their captains. Something they're doing a little differently this year. New captains every week. And from what Ezra Talaferro showed in camp, he's listed as one of those guys. End zone, Cato, touchdown! Gator Hoskins! Rakeem Cato to Gator Hoskins. And the tight end pulls it down. Harold Gator Hoskins from Cato. Cato back in it. He likes to celebrate. Treadwell in the backfield. On the option, he'll pitch the green, and he'll lose yardage. DJ Hunter was in the backfield.
I mean, that is, to be able to run an offense this efficiently, it's because you have a good offensive line coach.
They run it on second down. Butler's got some room. Across the 45 for a first down run out by Deion Nunley. 10-yard pickup, and the offense is looking fresh again, Randy.
Well, you always notice that offensive line coach, they want to stay at about a 45-degree angle.
Butler again.
They never want to look down the line of scrimmage. They want to look at it from behind, or they want to look at it behind the defense.
Cato throws out of the backfield, and yet another first down to the 32-yard line to Devin Johnson. Kern brings him down.
You notice with this offense that guys just seem to pop open, especially in the passing game. Suddenly a guy that was a lead blocker.
Third down and three. Talaferro, right side, got the room. That's an easy pickup of a first down.
Boy, this offensive line, Garrett Scott on the outside, who's the big athlete. They love the way this kid can move.
Cato keeps. Gets out of the pressure, throws to the end zone. Touchdown, Wilkins. You give him time, he'll eat you up. A 16-yard strike and a 2-touchdown lead.
Say, this guy gets out of the pocket. That's when you better really start worrying about him. He's not out there to beat you with his feet. He's out there to beat you with his arm. And he's going to beat you with his nerve. This guy's got like a cat burglar out there, the way he can fit something into a small area.
Hague with the extra point. And now it's starting to feel a little bit like Marshall football. Find Craig Wilkins.
Well, look where Rakeem Cato puts this ball when he gets out there. It's not like a normal throwback. Look at the height. I mean, no matter what happens for the defender, he's throwing it where Wilkins can go up and get it. I mean, it's not as high as I watched Joe Montana throw to Dwight Clark on the catch, but he's throwing that where only his guy can get it. You've got to buy your defense some time and get some points.
Runs into his back again. Stays on his feet for a moment. G. Jermaine Holmes, after he ran into Spencer Treadwell, takes down Austin Boucher. How many times have we seen
that
tonight?
Look at that. Only way you can make that worse is to run up into one of your offensive linemen and run into his butt and fumble.
Has that ever happened?
Nah, not in real football.
Yeah, you talk about these speedsters that they've got. Smith was the fastest in the 60-meter indoor. And they're trying to turn him outside to let him go, the man they call Moo Moo.
That's got nothing to do with speed. I know that.
I don't want to know what
it
has to do
with. There's a heck of a story behind that one.
Third down and one for Cato. He'll keep it. Oh, big hole. Gashed him. Slides down.
Yup, but club, grass.
Exactly what you got. Inside the 35. A clump there of 12. Second down and 10. Cato with time. Now pressure comes. He lets go. End zone. Touchdown. Gator.
That's the problem you're going to have when you face this offense. If you get this immediate pressure, you better get him. Don't let these inside receivers keep running their routes. He's going to be wide open.
Slow start, but it doesn't take them long to get started once they go.
No, it really, really doesn't. And they're doing it with pretty consistent pressure. You know, Jay Peterson's defense has gotten in Rakeem Cato's face. They have hit him. And this is another good example. I mean, he goes to scramble, and he's got to scramble. Because he's got somebody right up in his kitchen. Does it bother him? Eh, not particularly.
You might want to have somebody within 5 yards of Gator Hoskins.
That was a problem.
That would help the rush.
Albright got the pressure. He was where he was supposed to be, but no one was on the tight end slash slot guy.
So a tie ball game at halftime has gone all green. 35-14. He's been given that face a lot tonight, too. That "what are you doing" kind of face.
Yeah.
All night long. And they finally figured out what a lot of guys are doing on an 8-play drive. 66 yards, 304 off the clock.
I think it's one of the problems when you.
The man who led the nation in passing yards last year.
I think America, if you're a football fan, if you just love football, catch whatever games you can get when you get Marshall. Catch us here on the CBS Sports Network, but watch Rakeem Cato because he will entertain you no matter what.
Sends Green in motion. We'll keep it. Can't spin out of that one. He got laid out again. Evan McKelvey. They are 2 of 9. This is a third down and 10. Straight up, good for 2 yards and nowhere close.
Make that 2 of 10.
There you have it. Curious call on 3rd and 10 from that territory, and maybe the intent was.
Knowing you're going to have a 4th down, mm-hmm. You're going for it. Good call, Brad. That's. And at this point of the game, at this point of the landslide, you want to get more of an impediment out there to stop this avalanche.
Boucher started 9 of 12 for 150 yards and a TD. He's 1 of 6 for 15 yards since. Throws here, knocked away. Incomplete, turnover on downs. Going for Alvada Jenkins.
Nice play by Darrell Roberts getting that hand in there. Got that right hand across the bow. Knocking the ball out. Watch 7. Roberts come in here. Nice right hand rake right across the inside of Will of the receiver.
Well done.
For a lot in the second half.
He goes right side again. Scoot out for 7 or 8. Rakeem Cato, the man can strike and strike in a hurry. Gator Hoskins one time. Craig Wilkins. That would make 2 TDs. And even under pressure, let's go back to Gator one more time. 21 points in the third. And the man he's trying to emulate, at least a little bit, is down on the field with Rashawn.
All right, thank you so much, Brad. Here with NFL great Chad Pennington, a man that has made an indelible mark here in the Marshall program as a quarterback in the 1990s. Let's talk Rakeem Cato. How happy are you that he's continuing the quarterback legacy here?
Well, Rakeem's doing a great job, and what's really awesome for me to watch is how he's grown not only on the field but off the field. It's a kid that's come from inner city Miami, and now he's starting to get what it takes to be successful both on and off the field, and he's doing a great job with his leadership.
Absolutely. You talk about making a mark on the field, but off the field you're doing the same thing. Mike Fury, the wide receivers coach, now you were responsible for him getting the job. How special is he?
He's very special. I think he's going to be a great coach. We played together at the Jets. Mike was an unbelievable receiver in the slot for Mike Martz, and I'm really excited to have him here. We stole him because he's a great receiver, and now he's a great coach. And the receivers in that room, they respect him because of where he's been.
I know the Marshall faithful are very happy that you're here. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It really is. Always was an extremely high-character individual, college, pro. I thought, in my exposure, my 25 years since I retired, maybe the smartest player, coach-like player that I'd ever been around.
Really?
Just, he was a grinder, as he described himself when we talked to him. He was there, when he got drafted by the Jets, first thing he asked for wasn't the check. He wanted the key to the facility. So when he got, because he knew he'd be getting there before everybody else.
Well, he said he was putting in, what, 16-hour days?
Yeah. You got to do overhead presses. What's the deal? I mean, is that a workout program?
If you're going to go to the game, you got to get a workout in.
Okay.
Oh, laid out at the 15-yard line. Hewitt. And Tosh Luttman. Miami was second worst in the country at stopping run last year. And Cato is up, loaded up, and Boucher is laid out across the 21-yard line. DJ Hunter made sure it brings up fourth down.
This Marshall team strikes me as kind of the anti-Alabama. You know, hear people talk about Alabama. Well, if you don't play them hard and physical for all 60 minutes, the entire game, they will beat you. But if you don't play these guys cardiovascular the entire game, if you're not running and gunning with them the whole time, as soon as you stop for a deep breath, they score two touchdowns.
How do you physically prepare to play a team like this? You can't duplicate this in practice. Big hit by Murphy. Trash Smith back inside the 20. He's dropped at the 30-yard line.
You got to have really good depth of guys that can run and be physical.
Miami jumps. Free play for Cato. He's going long. Got Shuler. No, he's got Smith in the end zone. Touchdown, but there's a flag on the field. I think the free play will mean a touchdown, Marshall.
But 81 plays, over 500 yards offense. You just kind of let your left.
Picked. Inside the 10 to the goal line.
Did he step out?
Waiting on a signal, touchdown.
You learn and groom at your own expense.
Second down and 6, and almost another pick. Tindall was there.
Yeah, watching him in warm-ups, this kid can rip the ball.
Pitch left side, Butler. Room for another first down across the 40.
With a quarterback like Cato, they could get a lot more yards passing.
Butler again. And now finishing up with a backup quarterback. Fronapple finds a wide open man. It's first and goal inside the 5-yard line. Joe Woodrum gets a little playing time and takes it down to the 4. It's all Marshall in the second. And that'll do it. 52-14. We wondered at halftime, this is something different. And the second half is exactly what we expected throughout the entire game. Doc Holliday gets the win. Rakeem Cato with 5 touchdowns. Your final thoughts, Randy?
I'm very impressed with Doc Holliday's football team. I think this is a team that can do some serious business if this defense can keep playing like this.
Inside College Football is next. Our first Saturday is a thrashing by the Marshall Thundering Herd of the Miami Redhawks, 52-14. For Randy Cross and Rashawn Ali, I'm Brad Johansson. Thanks so much for joining us.